Let's make a little couscous. Follow the directions on the box. But then after that, we're going to add all of these ingredients to build it up. So it's really just a meal in itself. You can use whatever herbs you want. I'm using oregano and thyme, fresh garlic, carrots, celery, shallots, and black beans, and chicken stock. And the first thing I'm going to do is to simmer the thyme and the oregano, because I'm too lazy to pick off the leaves and mince them up. But I would say that the amount I'm using would be equivalent to about maybe 2 teaspoons of each, or 1.5 teaspoons, which you would add at the time of sauteing. But I'm doing it this way, it's just simpler for me, and I'm going to get the flavor out of it. So I'm starting up with more than what I need in chicken stock, or you could use water, or beef stock, vegetable stock, whatever liquid you want. And as soon as this comes to a boil, then I'm just going to simmer this for about 10 minutes. And the flavor will come out of the herbs. I will strain it through the chinois and use the correct amount of liquid as it states on the box. The other thing I'm not going to do, when I tell you to use the ingredient, what it tells you to use on the box, I'm omitting the oil or butter at this point, because we're sauteing vegetables in either butter or oil. So we'll be putting in the correct amount of oil into the couscous later on. I love the aroma of the fresh herbs. It's always better to use fresh than dried, but fresh dried herbs do a good job. Except for tarragon, rosemary, which I never use dry. I'll only use thyme, sweet basil, oregano. Well, it's been simmering now for about 10 minutes. I've extracted quite a bit of flavor out of the herbs. And now we're going to strain it and go about just putting the couscous together. And now I'm going to saute it, as you see, the vegetables that I'm using today. Shallots, carrots, celery, and a little garlic. It could be cauliflower, broccoli, carrots. It could be zucchini. It could be anything you want. And even more than this. But this, I feel, is the right amount that should be mixed to the couscous. And maybe we'll see the couscous with all the vegetables. You never know. So first thing we're going to do, as I said, I'm going to saute the vegetables with 2 tablespoons of olive oil, which should give me enough olive oil to be mixed in with the pasta, following somewhat of the directions on the box. And into this I'm going to put salt and pepper. So while this is sauteing, I'm also going to put the couscous into the very hot, which I'm getting very hot right now, stock water, or whatever you're using, liquid. Now while the vegetables are sauteing, and they have to cook all the way, you make them the way you like, a little al dente, soft, whatever. And meanwhile, I'm going to put a little salt and pepper into the stock, and that's going to be hot in a second. You see the steam coming out of it, which means we're ready to put the couscous in there. Now, if you don't have a pot with a very tight lid, you can always take a small pot and take a piece of aluminum foil and wrap it around. So when you put the couscous in there, the water's boiling. I'm going to shut the water off right now. That's it. We're going to give this a mix. That's it. Cover it up. Follow the directions on the box. It says 5 minutes. So we'll set the timer for 5 minutes. and we'll be back in 5 minutes to look at that. Meanwhile, the vegetables are sauteing. You know, I've even put, towards the end, I put a little white wine into this, let it reduce, just to pick up that flavor. There are a million and one things you can put into the couscous. And I added the black beans to it. The black beans are, I use canned black beans. Why? The small amount that I'm using, I just wasn't in the mood to cook up the beans. As you see, the only reason I put the black beans in there was for color. If it looks good, it'll probably taste good. So that looks good. I would put peppers in there also. If I had a red pepper, I would have put a piece of red pepper in there, but this is what I had laying around, so this is what I'm using. And couscous, we know, is made from wheat flour, durum wheat, which is a little bit more beneficial for you than eating regular white pasta. I mean, it may look white, but the couscous is much healthier for you than eating white flour. So, it's a pasta, easy to cook, and I'm even going to add some cheese to it. So, just saute this, and make sure the vegetables are cooked the way you want. When that's done, we're going to toss it into the couscous. Okay, the bell went off, 5 minutes. Let's see if we did right. You see, you can't fail with those directions that are on the box. Look at that. It's not sticky, it's fluffy, because the people that write the recipe on the box know what they're doing. Now we're going to add all of this, because this was done actually the way I like it in about 5 minutes also. And let's see if the amount that I'm adding is the correct amount and volume to the amount of couscous that we have. You know what it needs? Green. So you want to put a little fresh parsley in there. That would really make it look pretty. Let me taste it, because we've seasoned both the vegetables and the couscous. Now I'll make a plate, put a little cheese over it, see what it looks like. Well, the amount, I can make two plates from the amount of couscous that we just made. And I'm going to put a little grated cheese in there. Fresh grated Parmesan. Just because I like it. And since it's pasta, cheese goes with pasta. And all of these things, I mean, whatever goes with, even, you want to put tomatoes in there? Dice up some tomatoes and throw the tomatoes in. That's good enough. And for me, I'm adding a drop of the hot sauce that I like, because I like it hotter. So that's it. Hope you enjoy it.